up every morning wishing I could do right by you. But as I open up the curtains, all the plans that seem so certain fall through. And yeah, you love to point the finger, but you know this love will linger. Shatter, you call out to me, and I'm there. Baby, don't go. I hate the thought of losing control. No, baby, don't leave. I'll see you in the morning. Back door open for me. Well, I go to bed each evening thinking that I could live without you.
Hey, faggot. Are you all alone? Where's your boyfriends?
Leave me alone!
Hey, where do you think you're going? Fight me.
No.
Why not?
I don't want to hurt people.
Only queers don't want to hurt people. Pansy.
But we're only the age that we are. You might not have knowledge, but does it get you that far? 'Cause I came to the morning with a lightness of touch, while the day is your limp and the night is your crutch. Running from Cupid like an oncoming storm. You can feel love that's given from the moment you are born. You are born.
Hey. What's that you got? My name's Cameron. My dad calls me Cam. What's that in your box? Can I see what you have? Can you talk? Then why don't you? Well, I didn't mean any harm. I'm gonna go now. Sorry you didn't want to talk.
Don't get too close! They could fall over any second!
Whoa. Sorry. Sorry, just didn't want you to get hurt.
Tony. My name is Tony Twiston.
Nice to meet you, Tony. Where do you live?
Over there. You can't see it because of the trees.
Yeah, I guess I can't see through trees. Do you like cars?
You have cars?
Yeah. Come on.
This one's my favorite.
I got it about 3 years ago for Christmas. My mom used to put together these shoe boxes and fill them with all kinds of stuff. Like pencils and pads of paper. Sometimes even candy. But I always loved the Matchbox cars the best. Wanna see it?
I might break it.
Nah, they're pretty durable.
I've never had a car like this. My mom and dad took my toys away because they said that I was too old to play with them.
You're never too old for toys. Even my dad has toys. He builds model ships and puts them in great big bottles. You can have it.
I don't know if my mom and dad would want me to have it.
Then just put it in your box.
I couldn't do that. It doesn't go in there.
Okay, well, you can always come play with mine.
My grandpa always told me that we should find beauty in everything. He used to take me on walks and show me all sorts of things. I've always liked butterflies and moths and beetles. Because even though they're dead, they're still beautiful to look at. This is a Denauge plexippus.
A do what?
Cam? Wow. Man, my back is killing me. We having company for dinner?
Hey, Tony, you want to stay for dinner?
My dad makes the best spaghetti in the world.
My grandpa always told me that I should be home before dark, and that soon.
But it's still light out.
And my dad makes the best spaghetti.
That with long noodles?
Yeah, how else would you have it?
I've only seen pictures of it, and I like the short noodles.
Never had spaghetti? You'll love it.
Okay.
Well, come on.
All right, here we go, fellas. Careful, it's hot.
Thanks, Dad.
No problem, buddy.
How was work?
Not bad. Feeling pretty sore. How's school?
It was pretty good.
Yeah?
Yeah. I think I got a good score on a science test.
Fantastic. That's wonderful. So, you had class together?
No.
No?
No.
How'd you guys meet? Just out on the schoolyard?
Yeah, on the field.
Yeah? Out on the field?
Yeah.
Here you go.
Thanks.
I really like your box there. Looks like you put a lot of work into that. It's pretty artistic.
Here, Tony.
Hey, Cam. Do you mind passing the sauce?
Sure thing.
Thanks, kiddo. Well, it smells pretty good. See what it tastes like. Here you go.
Thank you, Dad.
You're welcome.
Here.
Now, if it's too bad, if it's terrible, just keep it to yourself. I won't force you to eat it at all. I wonder what happened to the one from last year. Each year we spend good money. All right. Dig in, boys. It's not too bad.
It's all right. Here, take your fork like this. Then put in your spaghetti like this.
Hey, come on, Barb. Sure,
twist it with your fingers. Then you eat it. See? Easy. Yeah, you got it.
I want to try a little less on the fork next time. So, where do you live, Tony?
Over there.
Your parents aren't going to get upset that you stayed for dinner, are they?
No. My grandpa just told me to be home before dark.
I'll, there's plenty more of that if you, finish what you have.
No. I should probably get going.
But you haven't finished your spaghetti.
See me standing here all alone. Beyond this empty field where nothing's grown. This place used to be good when I was young. But now all that I have heard is worth the crows have sung. They sing Scarecrow. Scarecrow, where is your heart? Scarecrow, Scarecrow, do your part. Scarecrow, Scarecrow, where is your mind? Scarecrow, Scarecrow, did you leave it behind?
My dad usually lights the fires. Give it a try, but don't burn yourself.
My grandpa showed me how to do this when I was little, before my mom told him not to come around anymore.
Why would she do that?
She said that he was spoiling me. But it was more than that. He was only trying to help.
So she just told him he couldn't be around you anymore?
Pretty much. She said that I couldn't trust him, but my parents were the ones that were talking bad behind my back, saying that I was retarded, that my life wasn't going anywhere. My grandpa said that they were wrong to do that, and then that's when she said that he couldn't come around. It got worse after that. And they kept calling me names, saying that I'm dumb.
I don't think you're dumb at all. And people shouldn't say those things. My dad always says, never judge a book by its cover. And never say things you wouldn't want said to you.
You don't think I'm dumb?
No, not at all. I don't think that way about people. Especially not my friends.
Friends.
You got that right.
Hey, Tony. Finally got the fire going, I see you care.
Actually, it was Tony.
It's a pretty fine fire, if I say so myself. I tell you what, you boys finish cleaning up all the sticks and branches laying around, and I'll go make some of my famous hamburgers.
Wanna help?
What do I do?
Cam will show ya.
Nothing to it. Just pick them up and throw them on the fire.
Cam, I'm gonna go and get started.
Okay, Dad. Thanks.
No problem, son.
Just pick them up and toss them in.
Fan of my burgers?
It looks really good. I'm just thinking.
Anything in particular? I was thinking maybe it might be a good idea if I met your parents, Tony.
No. It's all right. I'm old enough to take care of myself. My grandpa said I was.
Okay, well, I really think I'd like to meet him.
Dad, it's all right.
They're not even home. My dad's at work, and my mom's with a friend.
Oh, so your mom will be home tonight?
No. She just told me not to make a mess of the house. But she always says that. I even have keys. One's for the front door, and one's for the back.
Dad, could Tony spend the night?
Oh, I guess that's up to Tony.
Wanna spend the night?
It's already time for me to be home.
Tony, I'm sure your grandpa would think it's okay. Especially since no one's home. Maybe you could, get some clothes and sleep in.
Dad, I think I have a shirt and a pair of shorts he can borrow.
All right.
You don't think grandpa would be mad?
No. I think he'd be happier staying with friends.
But where would I sleep?
I can take care of that for you. You boys, clean up around here and I'll see what I can whip up.
Thanks, Dad.
I got something special in mind for you.
Mr. Barry? If you ever meet my grandpa, would you tell him it was all right?
I certainly will.
Hey, Tony. I have a question. Don't you like marshmallows?
They feel funny on my tongue.
Oh. What's your worst fear?
What do you mean?
You know, like, what scares you the most?
Like ghosts?
No, like in your life.
I guess my mom and dad.
Do you think they'll ever change? Become nicer to you?
No. It's just the way that they are. They're not like my butterflies. They're not pretty. It's just how they'll always be.
Why do they scare you?
Because of how they scream at me. Like, if I walk too loudly, or if I keep the refrigerator door open too long, or even if I'm just sitting there, doing nothing.
Have they ever hit you? I'm sorry.
That's why it's hard for me making friends. Because I have a hard time trusting them.
But you trust me, right?
Yeah. Friends.
Best friends. Yeah, I wouldn't want to eat that one either.
Burned up.
Like a fireball. Wanna go back in the house now? Hey, you don't want to forget that?
Oh.
Whoa! That's awesome! Thanks, Dad. It's amazing.
It's not too bad, is it? Kind of reminds me when we used to go up. I really think you needed one of those.
Hey. Go ahead, take a look.
I think you boys should be pretty much set for the night. There's, snacks on the table and sodas in the fridge. I think you can find the bathrooms on your own. Oh, and if it gets too cold, there's some extra blankets in the tent.
Thanks. I'm okay.
Just okay.
It definitely helps having someone around to talk to.
You two are good for each other.
Yeah. We are.
Let me tell you something. You will always be my little rugrat. No matter what happens, no matter how big and bad you get, no matter how much one day you'll be able to
whoop my ass. No matter what happens, you'll always be my little rugrat.
Don't forget that. All right.
Okay.
Go have fun.
Okay. Which side are you sleeping on?
I always sleep on the left.
Do you like my dad?
He's really nice.
Yeah, he treats me well.
I'm sorry about the hamburgers. They just didn't feel right.
But you like the spaghetti, right?
I like the noodles. They felt all right.
It's all right. I'll tell my dad to make you whatever you want tomorrow. He should have been a chef.
Would he make me eggs?
Sure, if that's what you want. My mom used to make us breakfast all the time. French toast, eggs, bacon, fruit, you name it.
Where is your mom?
Wait here. Dad took that picture a couple years ago. We had just gone on vacation to Tequamanon Falls, and she was so happy. About a year ago, she came into my room and asked me if I wanted to run up to the store with her. It had been snowing pretty hard that day, and I really didn't want to go out into the cold. So she went anyways. A couple hours later, a police officer showed up at my door. My dad answered the door and talked to the police officer for a few minutes. He started crying. He took me out onto the front porch, told me that my mom had died in a car accident. I didn't want to believe him, but I knew it was true. I miss her every day.
goat do bad things. Like how my parents are. Makes things hard for me. And like with your mom passing away, it makes you sad. But you've helped me realize that not everybody's bad. And not everybody judges you just because you're different. I think you also feel like you're alone. But you're not.
Yeah. A lot of the time.
And I'm sure that your mom's looking down on you, thinking that she doesn't want you to feel alone.
Yeah. And I think she's happy I have you to talk to. This is gonna be a great summer.
Do you think that maybe there's more spaghetti left?
Wanna check? Are you still cold? It's not that bad. Just get down like this.
Cold.
You'll get used to it.
I'm gonna be your friend no matter what you say.
If I can find my fishing poles, we can go fishing tomorrow.
I went fishing a couple years ago, but I never caught anything.
Crystal Lake is loaded with fish. If we sat out there all day, we'd have enough fish for a week.
You mean that there were fish out there while we were swimming?
What'd you do that for? I see the little faggots hanging out with the retarded scarecrow. Don't call him that. What are you gonna do about it? Go tell your dad? Sick your little pet scarecrow on me?
No, Tony, stop!
No, Tony! It's okay, come back! Tony! I'm sorry, Tony. I'm sorry. Tony?
What's wrong? Pissed because you don't have your retard guard dog here to protect you?
He only did it because of what you did to me.
Too bad. You shouldn't be such a little faggot.
Kevin!
Hey, Tony.
Cameron.
What's wrong?
Friend, come.
Tony. Tony, you sit with him. I've got to get an ambulance.
Cameron?
Hey. I was looking for you.
Sorry I left yesterday.
It's alright. I knew you were scared.
Did he do this to you? I'm sorry.
I was trying to stand up for you. But in the end, you stood up for me.
I didn't want him to hurt you.
I know. I just wanted to let you know that you saved me.
But I wasn't there to stop him.
No. From the loneliness. You make me look at things differently now. Like your butterflies.
Yeah. It makes your heart feel better to look at things that way.
Tony, you're the best friend I could ever ask for.
Friends. Best friends. You're gonna be okay. You're gonna be just fine.
How long does it take to get someone out here? Look, my son is hurt very badly, and it doesn't help when you keep saying they're on their way!
You know, Cameron wouldn't want you to be so sad. You gave him an awful lot over the short time that he knew you. He never had a friend that he cared about as much as you. Butterflies. You taught him something very special. You helped him love again. His mother meant the world to him. When she died, he lost all hope. He was like one of those butterflies in that box.
beautiful. But broken.
When he met you, his wings began to mend. Both of you, you taught one another something that was very evident when I watched you talk to one another, play. Now, he's with his mom again. Yeah, but he wouldn't want you to be sad. He'd want you to know that his wings are fully mended, that he can fly again without any pain.
I miss him a lot.
So do I. More than I can say.
Do you think maybe he's watching us?
Yeah, I do. I can feel him in the wind. I can see him in the sun. And whenever I see a butterfly now, I know he's right there, letting us know that the friendship conquers all.
Friends.
Best friends.
There's mountains and hillsides and blue skies and fireflies all for us to see. There's bad guys in black ties with white lies. It's no surprise they're all for us to keep. If you take a look at our planet, you should clearly see that it's alright. It's alright. And despite of all the havoc, in spite of all the madness, please don't cry. Please don't cry, don't cry, don't cry. Just leave your
me. That's what my good friend told me. It hurts you, it pains me to see a friend, to see a mate so weak. As I cried, you cried, these memories are all we have to keep. Just try and smile, just for him. As long as it's been, we still miss him. Whenever you are sad, just smile, please smile for me. That's what my good friend told me.